call it good afternoon or good evening, because it is something in between. I know how it is boring when I was attending symposia, how boring is the last session to attend, you know. So we are in the position of, first thing, we are tired of listening to everybody for last 8 or 16 hours. But still, I will take this opportunity to have a kind of interaction or a kind of dialogue with you. And what I have been talking to you is something against the theme of the course. Theme of the course has told you what are the ethics, what are the moral, what are the good things you should do. I'll talk about only bad things and what you should not do. Why I'm calling this is because if you have good things and bad things, it's very easy. There's a nice shortcut to attempt and take up the bad things faster than the good things. Why? We'll see in my presentation. I have completely called it as scientific misconduct, and the my name is here, email. This is the Indian Institute of Science Education Research, where we started in 2006 in 10,000 square feet. Probably I'll show you at the end of my talk how we are now residing in about 4 lakh square feet labs. So this is the thing. What I'll cover? I'll talk about the plagiarism, definition, type, scope, and examples. Why I have chosen this? Because now it is scholarly to talk definitions and scopes, but you don't worry about it. You can find out any books that you have. I'll talk something about the falsification, which is a complete COVID for the word plagiarism. Then I'll talk about the plagiarism tools, scientific negligence, copyrights, and most important, why people turn towards plagiarism and remedial and preventive measures. If you don't understand the first topic, plagiarism, definition and types, I don't think you lose something, because I'll go through, so those who do not have any background in this will have some background of. What is a plagiarism or scientific misconduct? To steal and pass off the ideas or word of another as one's own. He is an idea, I pick up and tell that this is my idea. This is a very simple form of plagiarism. To use another production without creating the, crediting the source, this is a very common in industry. To commit literary theft or to present as new and original or idea or a product derived from the existing source. If you have this machine, just put something here and say this is my machine. Just modification. And still, in other words, plagiarism is an act of fraud. It involves both stealing someone else's work and lying about it afterwards. There are two ways. I pick up something and say that this is mine. So this is a combination of crime. There's a lot of fun also in this thing. I have shown you two. I don't know whether you will be able to write this, but the teacher is telling, Tom, your cut and paste skills are really beyond reputation. Secondly, I need to tell you a presentation on the topic of plagiarism. If you don't have the time to prepare anything, just steal something from the internet. Third is a classical and eye-opener for the science student. Generally, when you plot a graph, I don't think you get a completely points on the straight line. Do you get? Never. Then what you do? Nobody is looking, just put that on that side. Eh? This is a very common practice to be done. So now the question is, and if you would like to have a straight line graph, will you correct it as right fit? All malpractices. Your call. Many times, teachers themselves tell them, find out a best fit. That means you are not getting the points on the same line, even within the excellent layer. So he's asking, Gopal, should I call it as best fit or should I call it as plagiarism? You have to answer that question. It is an appropriation of other person's ideas, process, results, or word without giving any credit. People feel that only process or the what is put in the paper, if you copy and quote it without using this. But it covers also ideas. Processes, which is very common, and words without giving an appropriate credit. Plagiarism is theft of intellectual property and is not unlike stealing from a commercial business. When you have a commercial business, you steal things, that is a theft. But this is the theft of process or the intellectual property. Many times people do self-plagiarism. What is self-plagiarism? You have published a paper, you try to put the same thing in the next paper, and without saying so and so said. For example, you say, take it, never say Natu in his earlier paper said, but you just quote it as if it is your own, okay? It covers including other person's idea, opinion, theory, fact, statistics, graph, drawing. Why I'm giving you this list? When I show you an example, how this has been misused, or actually spoken or written word of perhaps. Real problem is, can the words and idea be really stolen? That's a nice idea. But according to US laws, unfortunately, we, by sitting in India, we always think of US laws because that is what is governs. The answer is yes. The expression of original ideas is considered to be intellectual property and is protected by copyright law, just like original invention. Almost all forms of expression fall under this copyright protection as long as they are recorded in some way. Now, this gives some idea. The original invention of Vanity Rain, when it came, the original fellow was an Indian fellow who sat and wrote that in a piece of paper how he thinks the Vanity Rain needs to be synthesized. He kept the idea as such. And later on, when it came, the Vanity Rain was developed by GlaxoSmithKline became. This fellow went to the court and said, I had the original idea. When you say idea, that is a concept. And within 1 year, then he saw the date. Then according to law, now you have to give the proof of concept within a reasonable period. And that reasonable period is generally 1 year to 2 years. Another famous example, there was a professor M.S. Vani. He published a paper in 1964 giving an anti-cancer compound, a big this thing, paclitaxel, the very famous anti-cancer comp. Was happy, he was awarded by college and all that thing. 1976, another company, again same, Pfizer, like GlaxoSmithKline became, took that compound, paclitaxel, and developed the wonderful A1 drug, which is a leading anti-cancer drug as on today by him. Now, since this fellow has not taken patent or he has never protected, his case was not considered at all, and they made money, and Vani remained as Vani. Fortunately, he is now in Canada and doing very well. I met him recently. He said, I have missed one bus, but I have several buses in my depot. That means he was intellectually enough to do that. But don't do that. Again, we were talking of legal issues and non-legal issues and several other things. Before that, let us agree that this is a moral, ethical, and legal issue has been around for centuries, but the internet and subsequent proliferation of information have made it. Somebody has published a paper on cyclic voltammetry of chromium in alkaline medium. A thesis was published in maybe 1970s or so. A new thesis was published on the same topics, everything, in a very, very renowned university. No history. Somebody went and who was not really looking, wants to put him down, searched and presented. Then he said, sir, when I searched literature, I didn't get it. Because in those days, the internet or these things were not available. Now, will you call him as a plagiarism or no? He has given an excuse, he doesn't know. So you had to give him a benefit of doubt at that time, but he was not given, and the university has withdrawn his degree later on. Many people think plagiarism is copying another's work or borrowing somebody else's original idea, but terms like copying and borrowing can disguise the seriousness of office. Copying means we have very, very little value with the word copying, because Xerox copying in it. In it, using word Xerox itself is a plagiarism. It should be photocopy. Earlier, we used to say, get Dalda. Dalda was Hindustan Lever's product. So these kind of things are sitting in our mind, and we should be careful about it. Plagiarism is an issue of great concern in academic fraternity, very important. Now, what can we consider as a plagiarism? Now, I have given an exclusive list. Consider a notable lawyer is sitting in the audience, and we should not escape anything from this. Turning in somebody else's work as your own. Copying words or ideas from someone else's without giving credit. Failing to put a quotation in quotation marks. He said, then you have to put it in the quotation mark and say. If you don't say, that goes under the plagiarism. Failure, giving incorrect information about the source of quotation. Many people do it. What kind of misquote they give? Suppose this is published in Journal of American Chemical Society. They don't say standard is J Americhem sauce. They don't say, they say J, A, C, H, and all the things. So nobody will be able to make out that journal and will be able to go back. So you quote the source, but in the wrong way, so that nobody will be able to understand. Changing words, but copying the sentence structure of a source without giving credit. I think I have passed on two slides to all of you. Have you? How many people have taken trouble to read their slides? You have sent it to everybody. Oh, you will certainly read. So I have gone to the one university to accept the synopsis. You know, there are committees where you accept the synopsis of the committee. There are four incontinuous ruins. Again, I'm coming back to cyclic voltammetry. Cyclic voltammetry of copper salts in alkaline medium, one thesis. In chromium salt, second thesis. So it is a continuous this thing, and it was literally copying word to word in the abstract. And when I didn't accept those research topics, result, I was thrown out of the committee. So believe me, you have to stick to the principle, otherwise you will be. I have given you this. Have you received at least these two sources? Anita, you had sent this? So I'm sure everybody has reached. I'm not going to go, this is a big thing. Our original resource can be converted nicely into plagiarism. Just go to one sentence. No oil spill is entirely benign. There is no such thing as good oil spill. This is a plagiarized statement. Just try to put it in a different language. Depending on timing and location, even a relatively minor spill can cause significant harm to individual organisms. If the time and place are just right, even a small oil spill can cause damage to sensitive ecosystem. So if you have enough alternatives, synonymous, you will be able to completely plagiarize, but if somebody who is an expert in the field will be able to make out. So this is a completely paraphrase. Second is word to word. Descartes has been heralded as the first modern philosopher. He is famous for having made an important connection between geometry and algebra. Plagiarize says Descartes is famous for being the first modern philosopher. He promoted a new concept of matter which allowed for accounting of physical phenomena by way of mechanical explanation and so on and so on. So you use bombastic words, but that doesn't allow you to say that is your own concept. Okay? See, I have particularly given this, so these are the big paragraphs. You just go home and just listen to this. There's another sort of, another crime, I will put it, because in the academic fraternity, it has to be created as crime. That is falsification. What is falsification? It is manipulating of the research material, equipment, process, or changing the omitting data or result such that the research is not accurately represented in the research record. What do people do? Research materials. They do not quote even the resources, source of the chemicals, research material, equipment or process. Thesis, you have to give one equipment, you record it. I'll give you one example. There was an There was a paper which described the NMR of a particular compound, and the way in which he has shown this record and NMR spectra, and he has in his elaborate experimental method, he has shown that the NMRs are recorded in 600 megahertz, which is wrong. So it is purposely trying to falsifying the data or the manipulation. So everything is done. Falsification also includes the selective omission, deletion, suppression of conflicting data without scientific or statistical justification. This is most common in drawing the graphs, figures. You know why X has to be in straight line, as I showed, but you never get it. Okay? Another best way, I'm sorry, I was also a party to it. In the, I don't know, in the FY taught to IBSC where you had to remove the parallax to find out the focal length, correct? They are very simple experiment. In my lifetime, this is one thing I could not do it, is the remove parallel axis. So I used to back calculate, knowing the focal length of the lens and varying the F, I used to calculate all the time. This is not correct. Then I realized what I am doing, you know. But please don't do that. Altering data to render a modification of the variance in the data, falsifying dates and experimental procedures in the study notebook. This is a very common thing. We are very bad at documentation. Let me openly say, we are very bad at documentation. We don't have anything undocumented. Therefore, Mashalkar has to play the Haldi war or the Basmati rice, in the, which was very difficult. Because there is no written proof that Haldi can cure the wounds or the healing the wounds. No written documents. And therefore, you have to document it correctly. Now, in order to bring that, somebody has published a paper and you want to show that you had done it earlier, you change, many people change the dates and external procedures in the study notebook. First thing, we don't have a habit to keep the perfect notebook. I have seen people go to the balance, take a piece of paper, write the weight, then just put the, this thing. We don't have a good habit of keeping the record book. Many times it helps, and many times it doesn't help. Like if somebody else has published, you cannot quote it earlier. Misrepresent result from statistical analysis. Statistics is one thing which you can play to your benefit any time. A man whose head in the fridge and the legs are in the heater has overall, on an average, he's a comfortable person. So like that, statistic can be played. Adding false or misleading statements in the manuscript or published error. Falsifying research accomplishments by publishing the same research journals in multiple papers. Many times, what people do, they are not sure whether their paper will be accepted. So they send it to 3-4 papers. Now people are very careful. When you submit a paper to a standard journal, you have to write and certify that I have not submitted this paper to any other journal. Earlier, that was not possible. And I have seen same paper published in 2 journals with the variance of dates, with the word-to-word copying. Ultimately, they were asked to remove. Falsified data in a continuous application for research supported by a funding agency. Misrepresenting the materials or methods of a research study in a published paper. Providing false statement about the extent of research study in an abstract submitted for publication. I'll give you an example in organic chemistry. When somebody does some 2 reactions, A to B, nitration, reduction, or some 2 stages, and writes, in our pursuit of making anti-cancer compounds, we have done this. Now, simple nitration and the reduction, will it lead to any anti-cancer compound? So that abstract will look attractive and journal paper will be accepted, especially in the international conferences. So now, what they do is, you have to send the abstract with the reference. So these kind of things are not possible now. This lead to advice to my younger colleagues. Don't do any virtual experiments. I'll give you another example. There was a compound whose structure needs to be determined. So when I was talking, the student proposed a structure. I said, if this structure is correct, then by steam distillation, that should give out the toluene. Next day, the boy came. Sir, I got toluene. This is my toluene. He got it from the bottle. So he did a virtual experiment. Fortunately, I could catch him. So don't try any virtual experiment. You have to do science is practice. So you need to carry out the experiment. Manipulation of the result. This is really terrible. And many times it is tempted. I'll give you an example. Elemental analysis. CHN analysis. Whatever you get, you try to manipulate into fit into the formula that you are suggesting, molecular form. Please don't do it. It reflects. Many times when I go through the thesis, I realize the exact figures are given. Carbon 12.27, they get 12.27, which you will never get. There will be an experimental error. So don't try to do that. Okay. Manipulation of the experimental data. This is really a very, very bad thing, but unfortunately we have inculcated this into all this. Simple boiling point, measuring of the data, weights taken, calculations, everything we try to falsify because we want to fit that into the final formula that has been given. The answer is known. They say you have to get phenol. So all the back calculation goes and see that you get the phenol at the end. Don't do it. Physical and spectroscopic data. This is the way in which the people try to cheat. How they cheat? Now there are softwares where if you give a structure, they'll be able to predict the NMR data. In many thesis, I have seen that NMR data, that NMR spectra has been given as an original spectra. Unfortunately, they were not good in cut and paste, so that Aldrich's name was still there at the top, so he could be caught. Don't do it. Don't falsify any practical or the spectroscopic data, journals, publications, and it ends into the thesis. Type of plagiarisms. How much time do I have? 10 minutes. I request you to give 15 minutes. Is it okay, madam? Okay. So, source not size test. The writer turns into other work, word for word, as his or her own. This is a very common practice in Indian scenario. If you go to any Indian journal, I saw International Journal of Immunology published from Solapur has a completely copied version from the International Journal in Portugal. So don't do it, you are likely to. The photocopy, writer copies significant portion of the take straight from a single source without any alteration. Third is potluck paper. What the writer does, he takes something from here, something from there, mixes these three and feels now nobody can catch me. Okay, so just like potluck, you do that. Poor disguise, although the writer has retained the essential content of the source, he has altered the paper's appearance slightly by changing keywords and phrases, as I shown you. Labor of laziness. There is a still self-stealer and so many. There are several things. Another thing is forgotten footnotes. You need to explain that this is from others. You just don't give that footnote at all. You have to give the footnote at this thing, then misinformation. Two perfect paraphrases, as I said, matching elemental analysis and so on and so forth. Resourceful citer, I don't want to go there. There are several other types of plagiarism, I don't want to go there. Scientific negligence, I don't know whether it can be classified. What is scientific negligence? Scientists have provided erroneous information but have not set out from the beginning with the intent to defraud. I'll give you one example. He is predicting some synthesis and he feels that this synthesis should give this product, which has been proved wrong by others. Whether he has plagiarized, I don't know. This is very a thin line, you know. So this can be classified under scientific negligence. For these cases, not only the public is fooled, but the scientist is also deceived because he thinks that he's getting the same product. The scientist who experienced this self-deception is one who does not have premeditated plans to be dishonest. Basically, he doesn't want to be dishonest. but by his thinking at that time, which may be scientifically wrong, but he had not plagiarized it. So that is a very thin line of scientific negligence and the plagiarism. Here he doesn't copy anybody, but he gives the wrong impressions. He gives the wrong results, wrong interpretations. And so if at all you do not need to use a few words from other source, put those words in quotation marks or indents, add a footnote, keep the length of your quotation down to a few sentences. If you are jumpy and wants to make extra sure you haven't copied, then pluck some phrases from your essay into plagiarismchecker.com. Gives you all the snaps of what you should use, how you can prevent yourself from the plagiarism and so on and so forth. Hopefully you will never have to say what seems like plagiarism was just an accident. Please believe. Make sure that your hard work is rewarded with the grade you deserve. Many people feel that I have an Indian Journal of Chemistry paper with an impact factor, say 0.5. I have published, this is worth I am, but he feels that he can publish in Journal of Organic Chemistry by using plagiarism, which is not correct. I'll give you a few examples, cold fusion and AIDS. Two scientists, Stanley Pons and Magali Fleischerman, claimed success of achieving fusion at room temperature. Everybody, all physicists know, fusion at room temperature is very difficult to do. They did not follow the commonly accepted procedure for announcing their experimental finding. Nature rejected it from the experimental methodologies and insufficient detail regarding their experiment. Thus, in their haste to go public with the claim, their research method and results were not reviewed by a panel of their peers prior to the being released to the public via the media and so. They didn't even have the opportunity to perform basic control experiments of their own. All of a sudden, in a parliament or this thing, when first anti-cancer compound vincristine was made in India, it was not declared in the news, it was not declared in a scientific journal. It was declared in Bombay Assembly by Chief Minister Antule, showing that this is the first time this was there. Then K. Venkatraman, the father of organic chemistry in this country, said, I think the right place to publish a publication is journal and not a parliament. So in order to haste, in order to get, if you read some of the scientists' achievement in the newspaper, you will feel that we are almost there. New anti-cancer compound for such and such thing. It's a very common thing. You see it every now and then in the newspaper. If you really take this to be true, we should be completely sufficient of anti-cancer drug. By the way, India has not discovered a single drug up till now. You take it from me. So then, Robert Kellew, Baltimore story. This is not even tempting for the ordinary students. By in 1986, a paper, Immunology of Transgenic Mouse, was submitted to the journal Cell by Theresa, blah, 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 and raised. One fellow, Margaret O'Toole, researcher in the field of immunology, raised the question about it because that was one of the first paper in the transgenic mouse. For the example, transgenic mouse is a mouse where the desired gene has been inserted or the one gene has been reset. David Martimol, a former president of Rockefeller University, shared responsibility for the paper as one of the five authors. Baltimore discussed the disputed data with Kishi, and however, the records were scrutinized due to the reported disorganization, blah, blah, blah. 1986, and NIH also cleared, but in March 1991, NIH concluded that lamination Kiri forged entire set of data. Paper published in 1986 involving the Baltimore, who was the president of a US university, in March 1991, Vidya, the Imanishikiri, has completely forged the entire data. In March 1991, Baltimore finally requested Sale to retract the paper in question. He cited in apology his defense of his colleague was fueled by my respect for Dr. Kiri's demonstrated abilities as a scientist. Nothing worked. Finally, the president of the University of Baltimore has to resign because of this. There is a very interesting story. I don't go by the water said. You take very simple terms, you take some, say, salt or anything. You keep on diluting. In one of the experiments, they decided a solution which theoretically, if you calculate, goes below the Avogadro's number. That means theoretically, there should not be any molecule present in that. And that drug, he said, it is very active. Then somebody commented, if that drug is active, simple water should be also equally active. Okay? So there was a lot of crosstalk on this. These are very interesting stories. And this saying, at infinite dilution, what is the honest error or was it what is dishonesty? Then he was given a really benefit of doubt, and it left out that how you can, and the it was not done by anybody else, but a famous organic chemist called Ronald Breslow, who was about to get the Nobel Prize, and in a way. Go into details. Indian scenario. In India, absence of database of thesis and dissertation, now it has started. UGC had made it obligatory to submit all the theses in. But what about the previous one? So now they are trying to document. Plagiarism is project which is uncommon and difficult to detect even at the school level. This is something which is very serious. I saw an advertisement recently. I don't know when you can say it. The first year engineering project, BE, M.Tech, all the projects are available. You just contact this website for money. Just think the plagiarism starts or the scientific falsification starts at the school or college level. So I said, exhibition story. I was a member of a committee which was asked to find out the frauds in the exhibition. Now, every now and then there are scientific exhibitions. So I went to a place and find out all the 6 students had done only one experiment, solar energy from road breakers. A vehicle goes, the speed breaker violates and you get the solar energy. I was so surprised, in such a small place, 6 students had done the same experiment and none of them could answer a single question. It turned out that one fellow from Bombay had made all these demos. They were all similar. And that fellow forgot to remove in the label that was there. So this is very, very sad. And if it comes at the early stage of your life, this is very dangerous. We had to control this at an early stage to avoid the future culprit. Indian scenario. Photocopies of dissertations had to be used by other college in different year. They're very common. I say even the most respectable universities in India still are doing this or still involved. PhD theses are also alleged to use plagiarism practices. Not now, because now UGC has taken no action. India requires an anti-plagiarism policy in academic and developed in its own anti-plagiarism software, which has not been done. You tell me how many colleges, universities have the plagiarism policy? You have IT policy, you have several policies. Who have the plagiarism policy? What is the punishment that will be given and so on? So beware and avoid plagiarism. Otherwise, you may be another example being curtailed that XYZ controversy, as Baltimore's controversy. And so on and so forth. Published 2 papers in this reputed Journal of Biological Chemistry, first in 2004 and second in 2005. The figures in the second paper were not from new experiment, but actually plagiarized from their own previous publication. These are the basic gels. Gels taken out from the transgenic, by killing the transgenic analysis of that. 2 or 3 gels were just copying from one paper to the other. I don't want to name them, this great scientist comes from Maharashtra, so I don't want to name them. Author submitted 13 papers in 4 years. Measurement of arsenic was similar to a published paper from Japanese group on chromium-3. The chemistry in most of his paper is illogical. Chemistry itself is wrong. The instrumented cytenic paper did not exist in the department. A series of 4 papers, how to measure selenium, submitted to as many as journals, he listed as 56 co-authors on his paper. Just to keep everybody's mouth shut, he added 56 numbers to quote. You know which is the highest paper which has the maximum number of authors? There's one paper published in 2016 which has 1320. 1,320 authors. And they are completely justified in this, because that paper was on the gravitational line, the discovery of boson particle. The ethic, the work that has been done worldwide for last 10 or 15 years was boson. When they showed the existence of boson, they published a paper. You can go through that just for the interest of it. Synthesis of a natural product, enantiomer, was reported. All the methodology would have given the opposite isomer. Rotation, NMR, was the same as desired isomer. I want to get an isomer A from B. I did not get A, I got B, but I reported that I got A, NMR. Everything was falsified and was converted. This is again by a repeated organic chemistry in this country. A paper was published by the Academy Journal of Chemical Science in December 2000, synthesis and electrochemical properties, so and so. I don't want to go into detail. I would like to. 2002, a vice chancellor of the university published a paper on axion dilation black holes with SL2 blah, blah, blah model in Europhysics later, which was entirely cropping from a six-year-old paper by Renata Kalosh of Stanford in Physical Chemistry. Fortunately, that vice chancellor was removed, not because of plagiarism, but because of his other mischiefs. In 1996, a paper titled Influence of, I don't know, I'll just show you a nice example. Plagiarized paper, I can say. In 1979, a paper in Tetrahedral Letters on a nicotide skeleton was published. J. Conforth, who is a notable organic chemist or the bioorganic chemist, he carried out all the experiments given in that paper for next 3 years and has published and written. We have been unable to reproduce his reports in any single particular, whether of yield, chemical nature of the products, or physical properties of substance. We conclude that he did not, in fact, obtain any of the products mentioned in first 3 stages. Look at the plagiarism by a top organic chemist of this country. In that case, he did not prepare the reported product of any later stage. There are 16 compounds. He said none, by following the procedure given, none of the compounds can be obtained. He published 2 papers on that, by the way. Comments, your paper is a sack of raving nonsense. Thank you. Not only that, he wrote the phrases used were enormous disparity, effectively impossible, extremely unlikely, and not feasible in any meaningful practical sense. Now, can you imagine a leading organic chemist, how, when he receives all these things and paper is retracted, how it is shameful to the Indian science community? Why I'm showing all these things? You youngsters should not do this. Is a plagiarism, and the courts care for the copyright infringement. Whether it is a copyright, then the court comes and gives you punishment. There is no punishment per se up till now on plagiarism. Only on bad conduct he has been made to resign, and those kind of conditions were there. But no, now the situation is changing. Why people tend to towards? This is something which is close to the heart of the young faculty members. Self-destructive behavior as showing the tendency to lie, absence of guilt, unawareness of the consequences, false ideas, and so on and so forth. By nature, I am not aware of what is the consequences of this. People feel, jane do, zaudia kai hote the bogu. This is the kind of tendency we have, and that many times leads to problem. Communication difficulty, ill knowledge, and unable to distinguish. This is mainly because we think still in mother tongue. Let me confess, we still think in mother tongue. So English to mother thought, converting into English and producing, there are many, many other problems, because it is our ill knowledge of English was also responsible. Non-availability of electronics resources. For example, if you want to refer to a Patna University's 1905 thesis, you will not get it. Now you will see it. Diverse element in the reward system, material, section, station, and frame. This is what is, there is a peer pressure. If you don't publish, your, what is that form where you get 400 marks? API, your API will not go. So that kind of peer pressure is there. Under that pressure, many assistant professors, they are tempted to do that, you know. But I feel that please avoid this. Maybe in short gains you will have, but in the longer term, you'll never be able to do it. Perish or publish is a peer pressure, even in the higher education systems, which should not be there, where sheer number works. If you have 10 papers in useless journal, still you get 10 into some marks. But if you publish, say, one paper in Nature or this thing, that doesn't get counted. So please take care of that. Habit of reproducing textbook material. Now, why we are doing it? In the school, we have been taught, suppose a question is asked, what we have been taught? त्या प्रश्नाचं उत्तर तिथे सातव्या पॅराग्राफमध्ये दिलेलं आहे. सो वी हॅव बीन आस्क्ड टू प्लेगराइज ऑर द कॉपी इन ड्युरिंग द स्कूल डेज इवन. सो वी फील कॉपिंग इज नॉट अ व्हेरी ग्रेट थिंग, ओनली टीचर शुड नॉट नो अबाउट इट. सो दॅट हॅज बीन इनकल्कटेड फ्रॉम द डे वन ॲज वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ द एज्युकेशन. मिसकन्सेप्ट, पब्लिक डोमेन इज अ पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी. दिस इज द वर्ड वाय वी शेड. Public property, what we feel that anything in the public domain or public property, I can take it and use it, which is wrong. Anything in the public domain, if you use it, you have to take the permission. You have to quote, you have to do several formalities. Why we have been doing this? Take the example, this is my own theory. Take the example of Mahabharata or Ramayana, okay? Ramayana, old original story must be very small story, you know, Rama, Sita, going and. But every now and then, there is a sub-story to it. Jatayu, this one. That fellow does that, goes away. So, the things have been added. So, as the things have been added, people feel copying from the other is also allowed. And this has been done. I think who has published Mahabharata, big this thing, he has added 29 incidences which are not there in the original. So it is a, could be. This is a kind of reverse plagiarism. Then people think that you can add the stories, same way you can copy the stories. So this is there from day one, and Jatayu or Nardamayanti stories and all other things. Then what are the preventiveness? I think this is the one of the aims of this workshop. Awareness, training, seminar problem solving, institution should have the plagiarism policy, checkers, habit like spell check, editors, funding agency should not just go by the numbers. Ultimately, it boils down to the individual ethical conduct. You may find out 100 rules. Honesty in conducting research and reporting the same, if the number of the researchers who prefer individual advancement before the scientific integrity. This is one of the things that is inculcated in the minds of the people. I'll be benefited if I publish one false paper, but the institution name will go down. That nobody takes care. You should not do it. 6 days back, a vice chancellor in India arrested on the petition by Professor Sir, who had accused of plagiarizing his paper in biotechnology and also illegally using cobalt, a chemical substance from the university's science lab. He was arrested for unauthorized use of hazardous, which is non-bailable offense and carries a maximum sentence in life in jail. This has happened. I don't want to name it. Everybody must have seen it 2 weeks back. What happens in Germany? Karl Theodor von Gutenberg, he was a German defense minister, and he was the second man in Angela Merkel's cabinet. That means after Angela Merkel's this thing, he was to become the chancellor. He was such a powerful person. But University of Bayreuth stripped Gutenberg of his doctorate after he admitted substantially copying from other sources. He blamed the errors on his busy schedule, blah, blah, blah. But he had to resign, and he resigned from the German cabinet, and he will not be allowed. His degree was stripped off, so the condition. And who have escaped? Martin Luther King, I don't want to go into detail. Martin Luther King, Jane Goodall, Helen Keller, T.S. Eliot. They have been proved to do lot of plagiarism. But unfortunately, by considering their great contribution to all other things like Helen Keller or T.S. Eliot, they were never charged for the this thing. And in most of the statements, they said, we were not knowing that this is a plagiarism. I have a lot of examples on this also. Remedial preparation of databases, compulsory submission of electronic copy, preparation of database of article published in conference and journals in India, which is not covered by the international year. So if you don't have that, is it, I have published a paper, I had talked about it in the conference, but I have not given reference because I didn't attend the conference. There's no electronic evidence of this thing. Taking an affidavit from the candidate regarding no use of plagiarized material, this we now do. It's a mandatory that we have to quote. These are the some of the anti-plagiarism tools that have been used, which are free and which have the commercial values. And now UGC, what is the name of the software that they are using? That they are now, they are going to change it from next year onwards, which gives a more powerful. Now you'll say, what? Did I just copy this material from the books, articles and website? Yes, I copied it. But as a matter of fact, I did. But this is not an example of plagiarism, since I gave credit to the authors of this matter. Where, in next slide, is not copyright infringement either, since my short quote is allowed by the fair use of exemption in copyright law. So I may be excused from the plagiarism because I had taken most of it from the three books that have been published, Guiding Students from Cheating a Plagiarism, Student Plagiarism in Online World, which is a very, very common thing nowadays, Nature Views, Science and Engineering Ethics, and Plagiarism, the Internet and the Student Learning. I had taken most of the materials from this, plus my own way. There's also fun in plagiarism. This lady says, Mr. Trat, since you are pretended to write this paper, I only pretended to give you the grade. So she'll get the 0 mark. Plagiarism, but my roommate gave me permission to copy his pages and said I did not have to cite him. They are friends in the hostel. And the last one, if you too much do anything, what will happen? The full stops in these two documents are very common. So this is a plagiarized material. So this is what happens if you really take it to the other extent. My last slide, perhaps. You are talking of, what is this pictures? Anybody is around? The beautiful paintings, from where they have come? Somebody said arts and science. These are not paintings. These are photomicrographs of several organic materials, such as hippuric acid, hydroquinone, adipic, and urea. Can you imagine that this kind of structure, you can get it from the urea crystals? This is where white light is passed to the polarizer to convert to unidirectional plane polarizer. This is okay. But now there is a debate whether this is, can be copyrighted, can we take a copyright? Then said you cannot because of urea, urea cannot be painted. So, as you have nice interaction or the interdisciplinary efforts of arts and science, that also raises several legal issues. So, you get, there is a complete book on this electron micrography which anybody can refer. This is the picture of ICER where we have about 4 lakh square feet. This is our lecture hall complex. These are the classrooms where every seat has been provided with a microphone, with a clicker, with answering machine and whatnot. There are several things that have been asked. Only one thing we stick to old, that is the blackboard and the chalk. That we do, that we never replace. This is the chemistry building. This is where we started in 2006. We were standing in this corner and asking questions, will something come up in this? Now this is completely green campus that we are talking today, where the no petrol vehicles will be allowed after 2 years, only the electronic or bicycles will be available. There is a complete rainwater harvesting. All street lights are solar light as on today. So all these things will give us the green status of the building. And this is what we are now. This is the gate which you are talking about. and where our vision and mission is only to use of interdisciplinary sciences and impart of the symbiosis of research and education at even under even for the undergraduate. So these were the, in modern language, USP of ISR, but they are really true and executed to the spirit of those words. And I would like to thank you. If I have exceeded time, I'm very sorry. Chairman should excuse me to for the delay.
Sir, you are specifically invited for this and we wanted to listen.
Okay, very good, very good. By the way, I would like to invite all the student teachers to ISR. Write to the outreach at isrpune.ac.in. Come in groups, take the permission, and you come out. Now, Professor K.C. Mohite is organizing a big meeting in ISR. I said, you are always welcome. Only you have to fit in the mutual timings. You can come, see the things, and go. There's no problem. Okay? If there are any questions, burning questions, I can answer them anytime.
Question is that there's this website, Sci Hub, sciencehub.org. All right? So there are so many websites which are publishing research papers and they're paid. Okay? So my question is that if someone is actually copy-pasting the URL of the paid website on sciencehub.org, so the whole research paper is visible. So is that copying?
Is a 100% copying.
And if there are people who cannot afford,
even on Science Hub,
yeah. So I think couple of months ago it was, you know, the website was removed, but again then they found out a way and they're back.
I tell you one thing, this is like preventing somebody from downloading unwanted material. You know, I don't want to name it. We had laws. We have put several things that students should not see for these particular sites, A, B, C, D, E, F, okay? Then what happens? There are proxy sites or the proxy server created every day. So they take the help of those proxy server and go to those same website, correct? Now we said we'll put a filter with those proxy servers also. But now we have realized that in the world, every hour there are 6 to 8 proxy servers are coming. How to prevent? And when we are talking of ethical hacking and all other things, one girl had challenged me, sir, you ban us from everything. Within 3 hours, I'll open and give it to you. I said, don't give it to me. But the way in which the things are going, because of the strict firewalls that they are putting. And another thing that is being fueled is now, earlier, we used to buy journals. Okay? And the author do not have to pay. Now, authors have to pay and we get it free. So this is especially very bad for the Indian authors. Of course, if you have published good paper, you get rewards. And you can, for further papers, you can use those reward points to get it done. So these are the two statements that combinedly answers your question. But don't, yes. Anybody else? Yes.
बेसिकली म्हणजे दोन ग्रेड रायटिंगमध्ये दोन समान कन्सेप्टवरती समजा दोन विचारवंत एकाच ह्याच्यामधनं जर लिहित असतील तर त्याला आपण मग तसं म्हणू का
लाईक दॅट इज ट्रू बट रिअल द रिअल प्रॉब्लेम इज व्हेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड आउट द प्लेगॅरिझम फ्रॉम द थीसिस फ्रॉम मराठी थीसिस ऑन ऑल अदर इज एक्स्ट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट Because first thing, there is a play of word. Science, it is slightly easier to do it. I don't know about the law because I don't have any example of falsification in law. But architecture, engineering, and science, it is easier because there are tools available. Whereas poets and all other people, they use this. But one thing I would like to tell you one thing. I have to take a patent, that means I have to write. But if Lata Mangeshkar sings a song, she doesn't have to get a copyright. You have to take care that what it is in the public domain is not, cannot be copied. So copyrights are never, you'd never apply for copyrights.
But even for that, now rules are coming. The movies and
But I tell you one thing. These are not, this doesn't have sound footing of law. Legal, this is. It is coming up. They would like to also bring it 100%. There is no doubt about it.
In last seminar, I have gone there. They said their new field is coming up, that is writing. Indian scientists that are lacking in writing, they can hire author, different writers for their journals and all.
Yeah. There are journal of organic chemistry. They will write the paper in that format and give it to you. But that doesn't give you this real satisfaction of writing a paper. You should write your own commission. That is your own baby. I call this as surrogated mothers, you know. You don't need them. This is your own baby. You should write. You should try to reproduce. Unfortunately, English communication is the most important thing that is lacking in our system. We scientists or the engineers, for sake of convenience, we hate English communication. Even we don't recognize that this is an essential part of ours. And we land up in all the, many of the plagiarism cases, one from Nagpur or some other university, was there because he said, sir, I don't know the real meaning of these words. Yeah, that is a different story. Perhaps you should ask UGC chairman who can do that.
Sir, when we go to foreign countries, they are presenting their papers in their own language.
Yeah, yeah.
Why we have to
example, lady called UU2, who discovered artemisinin for malaria, was awarded a Nobel Prize 2 years back. Okay? When I met her, she was unable to speak a word of English. Somehow I had to talk to her. She was reluctant to talk also. That is a different story. But, well, since this doesn't fall within the purview of this symposium or this subject, I didn't touch that. I have very strong views on that. So, by the way, there was a resolution recently that all the law degrees should be in India, in Maharashtra, should be converted into Marathi. The vice chancellor was very wise. He told that fellow, what you say is right. Please, you are the chairman of the committee. You decide the textbooks availability, questions, who will set the questions, and submit me a report. I am sure he will not be able to submit a single report on that. But people keep on talking nonsense. There is no.
But the question papers are available in English,
Marathi also, but the textbooks. See, it's very difficult to format that way. Any other questions? You can shout.
National languages.
What is your good name?
Sriranj Menon.
Huh?
Sriranj Menon.
Sriraj, this, let us discuss this outside the purview of this, because this doesn't fall within the outline of the framework of the project. We can discuss this if you offer me a cup of
tea.
Let us not talk of our nation going down. First, let us try to improve and take a pledge that you will not plagiarize anything. That is more than enough to start. Especially Anita, who has initiated this on WhatsApp and which ultimately came to the truth. I'm also thankful to the principal and all other dignitaries who have shared their very important views on this. Unfortunately, I could talk not in the positive sense of the ethics, but negative side of the ethics, what you should not do. Thank you very much.